Now, good evening, everyone. The words now, Udota. Udota now means the heart of the matter with the regional, a regional from independent television. Udon come again. Many, many different things that happen for inside this country. And now, as they come, now we take them today. We just look at some of the issues. It gets one, but it's a rope insecurity small. But anyway, we're going to hear them. As we continue for inside program. My name now is Mark Paolo. I deal with my brother, my friend from the far left, Enofe. My brother, good evening.
My brother, good evening. My people for house, now good evening.
Okay, HU, I will be in Anua before, and you deal with us again. Good evening. Okay, HU, good evening.
I greet you, my people for house. I greet you now.
Yes, so another man, the scene face, and I want a special analyst. He needs to get to do with bookwork. They put hand, but now they tell say the one with this now don't be a solo book. We need to do many of that in general. Okay, Frank, good evening, sir.
Poor for studio now, good evening. Poor for house. Now well done.
Okay, Frank, make I start with you. This so a few days ago, was yesterday. So the Minister of Trade and Investment, when they talked to people for Senate, he say Ghana and some other African countries, that they lobby companies within Nigeria have made a commot go their own country. That not be slack for our face.
I know truth not really did that statement. Better truth not there at all. Because if you check what it happened for Nigeria for so many years, that kind of statement I'm not expecting from the first governor of Ekiti State, 1999 to 2003. And the man a lawyer, he still be businessman. More leave law for inside. As a businessman, you know, if you talk like that, say other countries, including Ghana, we want drag with the where companies with Nigeria go their countries. I don't believe that one. Because if I as a businessman, if I tell us from business aspects, since the Minister of Trade and Investment, those three things, suppose talk to us along that line. That kind of matter, and a person will not do business at all. He say, don't thief my customer. If you get what it takes for a customer to come, customer come with you, we will hide inside hole. Person, they say, come for junction. You not get signboard. You know, they come radio or TV to come and advertise. Where he open his store, now they come to buy. So, it's about trace waiting to make people the wrong come out. Not until they start. 322 private firms, they don't close down for Nigeria. From 2009 to 2014, 322. That time, we never get this democracy like this. Oga Buhari never enter. 2009 to 2014, 322 companies don't close down, they don't relocate. And 2015 to 2017, 116 again. 2015, where this administration day, 15, 16, 17, 196 don't come out, manufacturing companies. What about six companies in Nigeria at that time? Will be assemble vehicles, Peugeot, Fiat, all those ones. Now Ghana see can they come out? So suppose first business as it be. It's not like the way Nigeria be now. At the year we say some doctors don't come out for Nigeria, some nurses don't come out, some scientists don't come out, some lecturers don't come out. Now Ghana see can they come out? Where did they drive people? Not supposed to talk. Not be say Ghana. What you concern Ghana? So many industries, all those textile industries, including the one they've been in that time, by Eribo. Waiting in Ghana still cost them. So nobody's same as supposed to make along that line. Where if we say we miss them, we not get the environment to take to business. Okay, you want to do one, so you both do one. To attract people, you can't do two things. One, they call it do tax relief, tax holiday. Task break. We never have mature like that. The problem about that, you get with my peer, they tell me, because she get master's for taxation for University of Benin. She got to explain to me, also as a chartered accountant over 10 years. He said, that thing where government do, government don't understand that. I say, how? We can't cause argument. I say, how you say government don't understand that? She can't tell me, say, one, you say 10 years. For the first 10 years, you take work, no tax. So most companies from abroad, they'll come here, they'll register company A. 10 years, they'll close and down. The same company will get thoughts on that name, company B. So that's what they do over and over again, over and over again. So they can't take advantage of that hole. And Nigerian government not quite realize. They say they want to attract investors. No, they say some Nigerians, they connive with them to dupe us. We have over 11 trillion naira taxes. We miss for road now. We government not trace. I don't feel there's alarm. Now the Minister of Finance, there is alarm. Say, why they say but they come to run Nigeria? Now then the Minister of Industry, Trade and Investment, come they talk, say, na Ghana, Kossam, as they appear before the Senate Committee. So I don't believe, say, na Ghana. Because a lot of people don't come up for Nigeria. What about Dunlop? What about Michelin? They come up for Nigeria and go Ghana. One reason, say, we know they get better light. And that light tonight is today. So a lot of companies don't come out, not be Ghana or those things, Kossam.
HL.
Well, Nigeria matter, if we talk, we know go fee end them.
Let me today.
The minister, we know say now everything about Nigeria. Now story. Now I just feel say now another assignment where they won't give us now be that. Now be the debate now. Say Ghana, they don't carry, like our brother talk, they don't carry our customer. The layman on the street, no one understand what you they talk when they say investment, when they say tax holiday, when they say tax relief and all of that. The thing is, why the question where they ask some be say, why be say we know they fee get money where now they project say now will get from taxes and others. I can say, oh now because companies will be in Nigeria if they fold up. The next question where they expect where they ask, where they not ask, be why then they fold up? Why then they run come out? So to they say then they lobby, not be part of it at all, because nobody go even lobby anybody make it come out for Nigeria, because the way when it be now, not even incentive to go away. Companies where they don't need any further advice. You don't see them. They say see throat, they say no, see neck. They don't see them say, you know, they safe anymore. You know, they safe. May they tell they Nigeria, they do investment. No wise person will carry money, come a state, a country like Nigeria, where nothing they sure. Now, they cannot guarantee the safety of that person there, eh? Because even the Nigerians, where they, not feel talking about their own safety. They cannot guarantee the safety of their companies. Nothing is sure. Look what even happened recently. Ordinary football match. Now in Nigeria with Ghana play. Waiting can happen. Say they win, they qualify, we don't qualify. Who loves can take over? They begin destroy. They begin fight. So what is wrong with us as a people? So waiting they make the people they come out. Now at the expect, say government for the attack rather than to the point finger say na African countries, na they lobby. How you go say, person, a man, we don't know the value of his wife, go say, and my friend just take my wife from me. If they talk that one, come out for mouth, you must be a stupid man. To say, your friend take your wife. Where you day, where you take your wife? So where Nigerian day, where Ghana, they take all their companies? So the question where the minister, no fee answer. But I pity the minister. Because true, the companies, like our brother mentioned, all of them, they fold up. Not we say that they fold up in this sense, but then the worker come on, go a country where the climate will be more favorable. Not before Nigeria, where they look for 167 persons now, we enter trade. Assuming Chinese, Japanese, and the rest, they inside that train where they want travel from Abuja, go Kaduna. Then 167, and they find the last 1 week now, they inside bush. People will carry them, they talk to Nigerian government, say, not be saying our money we want, because if our money we want, we know what thing we do. We want, government know what thing they want. Me never read any book where they talk, where they want, what thing they want to, because they talk, come out of their video, say, government, they don't tell government what thing they want. And until they get that what thing they want, they will kill all the people. Any company will hear this, any foreign investor will hear this, you go borrow money from Japan, control them like that. You start business today, tomorrow, somebody will drive you away, say you don't feel work until they hear from government. So there is so much insecurity in the country. There is so much, how do I put it there? I don't care attitude from the hand of the government. Government do not seem to know there is a great disconnect between government and the people. Government not even they took care what thing they happen to their people. Otherwise, that kind of interview when they are say, what thing you think say it they happen? Not supposed to be because everything they glaring. It should say government never ready. Government never get that same commitment. But they fight. Waiting they chop them. They say warm they chop old woman for house. It they sweep ground. Meanwhile, where they sleep under, you not sweep them. They are the one where they chop you. It's under your mat, not before the floor. So government supposed to they look waiting they cause this problem where we get. Then they will address the matter waiting will be called frontally. Now small matter be that address the basic issues. Issue of security, maybe Nigeria, Akihis.
Anything, number, chief?
My brother, you see, that minister actually had nothing to say. He not see where one carry the matter pass. I know say he get where for Bible. The Bible say wherever the carcass is gathered, the eagles will come. If I go break and down, anywhere better for day. Whether now on that trail, now one kind of place when we say no, they presentable, you will see men with suits like our doctor will hold plates. They stay queue for ordinary food. So anywhere better thing day, people will come there, irrespective of how the place be. So that minister ain't not see where carry the matter pass. Like as my brother talk, I be businessman. The environment is so hectic. I get a standing business. I'm into logistics. I'm into hospitality. To run business, even for a Edo State alone, it takes a lot.
What are the challenges for you to face as a
brother? Excessive transaction. No, government encouragement. No, when you go even go seek for loans to even expand your business. The kind of process when they will even take you back, take you to. Even your own very bank, when we say you don't they do business with, to get a loan to say, okay, I want to expand, it takes a lot. Apart from that, the number one thing is insecurity. You know, yesterday I go fix my car, as they do, I see some boys just coming with their flashy cars. The mechanic won't tell me, he said, chief, not be all this money when they pay us, so we don't get better customers. I said, what did they worry you? He said, no, if not be all these ones, we for not they eat, so therefore they will carry you and your car from out here. So insecurity in our country, even as a businessman. My office, some of our staff don't carry money wrong. Why I bring this matter be say
to our staff?
Yes, now, sure. Carry. Because we then also into daily tributes. Mm. Money when they collect for customer with the company name. They carry around. And the company, now the people know who they will go pay. Now the managing directors of the family, partners of the company, now go pay. Why are they bring this matter in? Nigerians also, we get problem. Inside something just now, say, a company, the companies they come when we say Nigeria give them leverage. So that they will not say we even they welcome them. Now, our own very people, now I go coordinate with them, say, okay, do one like this, in 10 years, change them. Now, our own very people. Okay, which insecurity, not be another man be insecurity for Nigeria. Now, Nigerians, they provide, and they even ignite the insecurity for inside Nigeria. Imagine your own Nigeria, you kidnap 172 people. They demand from the very government of your country may they do so certain thing, and you collect your very citizen, your own very person, not business a foreigner, not expatriate, now your own fellow man who is a Nigerian. You the demand from government who is also Nigerian. Nigeria not get another government. Now Nigerians make up Nigerian governments. Let's come to what happened recently. They win us. They win them by ourselves. They destroy our infrastructures. They destroy the what we would already make, we destroy them by ourselves with our own hands. They use leg, they destroy things. Then at the end of the day, the government, they don't fail to do this thing, no.
They don't first do this project with, they say they spend maybe so billion. You don't destroy them again for them to come back and say they will increase the billions because they need to fix those things. When you use your hand, destroy. And these policies, they affect you as a citizen of that same country. So we get problem. The minister himself had nothing to say. He just had to carry a person because he get boss. He no one go talk something when we say, then he go come bring a boss, come and say, okay, you went to tell it to talk about security. Don't forget about the man when they sack, when they say in the house of better Nigeria for Abuja. They sacked him. So,
the imam.
Yes, now. He has been sacked. Why? Today he came out and said, is it wrong for him to demand for a better Nigeria? If it's a sin, he should go to hell. He will go to hell. So, Nigerians is the Nigeria problem. Until we have a reformed mind and a renewed mind, not tell me, say, minister, if you don't say you don't know the job, leave there. Leave there. How can you come on air? In fact, it's a shame on his part that he will come on air and say your neighboring country, they steal your investors. What are you saying? People, they hear you. You, they come on air. They told say your own investors when they your it's not supposed to just tell us that the environment is not conducive for investors. Plain up, but you're not gonna talk. Because if you talk, maybe the next day Google House. So the problem of Nigeria, my brother, is within us. And the solution also is within us.
You agree with that?
Yes, so because as we talk about that football where Nigeria and Ghana play, we not be apply that road to the correct person. As Nigeria can't lose for that match now, they say they sack Austin Eguavo and the rest. But as Nigerian president, now they perform now, we don't face the sack him. We will apply the same rule. If any governor for state now they perform, we will face sack him. If they say that ordinary people, they forget power. 27 cocoa processing factories, 90 Nigeria before. Now it don't turn to 5. And out of the 5 now, they call below capacity. Now they perform. Now Ghana still carry them come out. Cocoa now China. Call the start cocoa planting now. Later, call the Yoruba man go to buy cocoa from China now. We get things, not we protect. We they cry say na Ghana or other countries. Why they come out? What is our minister supposed to do? Since he's still businessman, apart from lawyer, still be businessman. What is supposed to do? Now this simple thing, let me know what they call SWOT analysis. SWOT. S na strength. W na weakness. O opportunity. T threat. So you look your strength first in any business. You analyze what will be our strength for this country to do business. Okay, we get weakness, insecurity, bad government policies, so many while away there. Well, those are our weaknesses. So which opportunity we can't get now? To take collect these people back to Nigeria. If they don't analyze that, you conclude the threat. They will feel calm, they will feel conquered, Boko Haram, what will we do? So now those things, ministers must sit down. Like some of us that like me now, I feel do all these things, not beside the campaign. Maybe they give us platform, I'll do something, this is very simple. You consider so many things. Maybe as chief talk, maybe minister they fear waiting your guy will talk. Say, you say that insecurity. Then the next thing say, well, I like to lie. You don't step down to like be that. You don't want losing job. But they look for Nigerians, we want to lose their jobs to speak the truth. But they look for Nigerians, we go ensure say the right thing they do. Don't matter what thing will happen. Now those Nigerians we need right now. Young people will get better sense. And I advocate for young people. Because if you go carry your Peking, go give your grandparents where they train, they go spoil them. But the small people do something, they don't feel talk to them. They say, see, I live on a small picking. But that small picking, they with the papa for house. You get ready, papa say, handle them. So now, so they see them now. So a lot of old people, they're not too many for the top. Even to the extent, the young people, they think like old people now. Even some old people, they reduce their height to become young people now. So at the end of the day, the Nigerians still suffer them. Now we create the problems. Now they try to solve the problem at the same time. People like say, we don't know what they do. All those they cause problems. You push them go one side. You supposed to not say this thing are not going to fit again. Then they can say they drag her with you. You're supposed to drag position with you. You're not say this thing are not going to fit. What you not going to fit? Not going to fit. You're not the right person. Come on board, do them. The minister, the ITI minister, in industry, trade and investment, suppose tell us what happened. Opt in and never talk. Do you not say even MDAs, they owe taxes?
Yes.
MDA, ministries, departments, and agencies of government, they owe taxes. But now common persons, now government they get power over. Your store, you not pay tax, the couple one sticker. This one, not that one, the couple sticker. So the big people who suppose pay tax, government agencies, suppose pay tax, they not pay. What did they do? Nothing. So FRIS get hand for all these things. Federal Inland Revenue Service, they get hand. Because that one get hand, then CAC, Corporate Affairs Commission, they get hand. Because if I do one business, say I don't pay tax for 10 years, then once it's done in 10 years, I'll go register the business again with the same board of trustees. Will change the name. Check on now. When my PA and my wife, when should they tell me how did they do it? She even wrote a report along that line. So they'll change the name, use the same board of trustees. So CSC is supposed to raise flag. Sir, government, minister, this is a Federal Inland Revenue Service. Look at what they do. Minister of, Finance. Look at what's happening. Minister of Investment, Trade and Industry. You alert them. You don't quickly show your face. Until they say they don't that one before 10 board of trustees. The same people with the board of trustees, now call it the other one. They don't close the other one. How do they do a system? So there are task relief, task holiday, task break, I don't know the name they call them. That will create your problem. And I will still show them how to maneuver them. Why are they not going to leave? If not me, I will leave now. For Benin say, oh, Dema Gala, I lie with it. But if you pass road, you block, you go to that place. Anything about investment or business, now money, and the money they expect, you know they get them. And after your pocket, because they carry money to the bad diesel, this is about 600 or 700 naira now. You don't give lights, you don't give water, you don't give security, you don't give anything, you expect them, make them stay back. You don't have to stay. You don't have to stay.
You come and see. When you see the way it is explained something, so kind of action we will see some of our leaders they take. You come like say the make us look like say we won't.
I tell you.
I mean, do you look at like that? Because for instance, make I still break down, you enter another country. As you enter another country, you don't feel by sin. Timiko. No fee, you know, even if you enter hotel, even if you enter hotel,
open account, no fee.
You know, if you open account, no fee, auto hotel, you know, if you do so many things because of the law with the ground. But you come like, say, when our own country, we know they see where all of those intelligence, put ourselves, all those intellectual coaching, they come. We're going to see when organs of government, it goes to kind of what they do, come like, say, we'll be mugu.
Well, now so it be like, I don't want to say now so it be like, because when you really look and you will say, why be say policies, government policies for us where it they work and our own not they work. Now, Sayomore, now he's singing for one song those days, he will say, now me know my people,
they go buy.
Anything, any product what you bring. My partner, they tell me those days too. He said, one day somebody will just rap. Nonsense. They said, I go say, make on a bow, you will just say, bring and come. Then the question would be, wait till you say, make the person bring come. The person only just say, make on a bow. Buy what? You have no ask, you just say, bring and. So that is what is happening in Nigeria. A little back to the issue of the minister. The minister can say, the tax relief when they even give one manufacturing company, the other day now, close to 50 billion. People where they manufacture nails.
Mm-hmm. For a village.
He said, no, people where they manufacture nails, because they made their export nails come. But he said, in nail manufacturing company, they in village. Say, you know, they work. Minister, then they talk to them, say, you know, they work. They can't say, why? He said, no, the cost of material when they will take producer, it is higher than the one where they import. That's why they continue to import, 50 billion. Now look at our policies. You talk to just now, if you go outside before you go buy ordinary SIM, they will want make you link that your SIM to your either your license or anything that will give you identity to the ID card. If you are booking for a hotel, you will say, don't like this. Don't. Now, say CB for Nigeria. But do we do it? We are so much in a hurry. You now, Mondrito, you know, say if you go hotel now, they can't say, Oga, bring your ID card. Say, you don't know me. Now, maybe I borrow law. They say, oh, Oga, now you go. Me will come. You don't know me. Now, maybe this will go. So now me know our people, it too many for the things what they do. But up to the point we say we no come, we can't throw caution.
When you say do caution, literally wait.
Yes.
He got off my friend, he blessed he did asset now. He named a preso. We always meet for one program for Manarata, one of our radio show. He always told it line what he told. I mean not the one to agree.
What is the line first?
If the necessary sanctions and necessary sanctions and government police are in place,
yes,
everybody go fuck you, now, fall in line.
Now, so you will think. Now, listen.
Okay, for instance, I feel tell you now, see, I talked this matter yesterday. In this country, for all the hotels, some say I don't go. Eh? I don't, for Abuja, for Enugu, for Kano, for Benue, for Kogi, which other state now? Delta. Many states, where I don't go. No one ever asked me, say, may I bring my ID card?
Okay, they know they ask you.
No.
Why?
Everything.
That's what we are trying to say.
So when you say, we.
I say, now the Nigerian factor.
No, but when you say we, it go be like saying, the people, where they, like me, ordinary man, or the citizens, now they get the force. If government put this in place, say this is how all these things should be done. Like I tell you just now, you know if you enter Ghana, say you enter any hotel without your international passport, why can't we have such things? How come that we'll go tax that you know, say the thing can make Nigerians, they very all intelligent to the world,
yes,
that all those apartments, yes, they see us finish. That this a refuse or a place where dollars full. You understand? That you come, you give tax relief, after 10 years, you register. That's a company with the same board of trustees to another product. And we this year, and we don't fit to anything. This same thing, you know, give you future for that Ghana way dimension.
Well, you don't already almost answer the question. Now, the Nigerian factor be that from the head to the bottom. You hear the other day for immigration when the chief want go do papers. As he go there, he this guy like ordinary person.
Yeah.
Come to say, okay, come. Man, we can help you like this. We can. We say, what does it cost to do that? See, this is it. Now say, before he now reveal his identity, because hey, sorry, sir. We don't know why. We don't. Stories go come. So that is the Nigerian mentality. Don't be say laws not there. Don't be say rules not there. But now for Nigeria, we they do what thing that they call selective application of laws and principles. You go select. For Nigeria, law, they look face. You go look. Now this man, no, we're not going to do it like that. Now that man, no, we're not going to do it like that. They will come tell you, oh, everything is at the discretion of the judge because the law is that. The law is what it is based on what the judge say it is. So if even when it is obvious and judge can tell you, say, no, you know what feel. For example, I give you an instance. In Kogi, recently, they can say two internet providers, Globalcom and Airtel, they owe 360 million.
Tax.
So government can say, no, they owe us this money. They now went to court. It got injunction. They go close down that company for about a week. They lock them up. Then Nigeria come, they talk. See, how they come, they say, oh, Luna. They come say, they pay tax, pay as you earn. When they work as they pay, you know, they reach government. They come say, why? Because this paying money where they deduct are source. Before you even pay the worker, government don't get you home. Why can't be say, store the day? Between the point of payment and where you go reach government. So they went to check. All the workers, they pay their tax. So where it come day? They come day, now even for tax office, and then they deduct them, they know they remit and make a hit account. Meanwhile, you don't they lock down the company, say they don't pay tax. So these are some of the things. And one will expect, say, if they discover such things, people here suppose rule, as it were. May they sack somebody. But who they will sack? Before you sack, somebody will give you a call. Hey, that person, I brought him. What happened? Say, oh God, he get with it. Please suspend that matter. Otherwise.
No, we won't talk otherwise. Once you say suspend,
you say, that person is my person.
You trust and obey.
That is it. Then you wait for the instruction. The instruction you will hear say, okay, what is the punishment? Just transfer, change the department, or do this, do that. So today in Kogi, 360 million naira is outstanding. And the people are saying they are not owing. That is the firm is saying, you know, they owe government. And the workers are saying they are not owing. Now, who is to pay that money? That is where the problem of Nigeria is. Now, so the insincerity on the part of the leaders and the led. Insincerity is so much corruption. You see, when you are talking of, insecurity just now, another problem is corruption. They will just say, is it not in Nigeria where yes is no? Somebody has told me that before. You say, oh, you are from Nigeria. Okay, that is a country where they say yes when they actually mean no. It is like that. It's rubbishing everybody. So when you will say, waiting they wrong with us, now the mentality of the average Nigerian, now, how it will take benefit me? No minding waiting will happen. The aftermath effect. Quata quata, I plead bargain. I go beg, say, I true true do one. But not kill me, not beat me. I go return
some.
A professor in Jam, for example, where they make money, they open firm, they open the internet. They do so many things. When they come catch them, come say, I will bring small part. I will bring this. In a common man, like they talk, say, selective application of law, he will go jail. But not be say me the advice, advocate now, say, make professor go jail. But if I respect that title, say, in a professor, and certain things, they say, if person don't pass the one where they find good, you go just say, next time, not one, we'll give you cow. Now, cow, you will bring home. So, professor, wake up, they return that one. No, he know what he do. And he know what he did. He know the law. Now, he can't do that kind of thing. Then you will come say, hey, well, Nigeria. Not be say the law not there. The law there. The law catch up. But punishment not there. So there is no punishment where it will attach to offense where person commit. They said, evil thrives because good people sit and do nothing. Somebody also said, evil thrives because good people sit and do nothing. Don't be saying for no change. Then somebody also said, he said, it is bad to be silent when you have something to say.
Before I go stop, where would it go, so Frank? You should see a solution there for our problem, so. Because who start from Edoya? You get one village where they call the Gojo.
Today. Two persons.
Kill some people.
They slaughter.
Because for A, we're not the one, because now human being, we don't give us all respect. Okay. If you see the way they kill those people, A would call it fear now. They start from one village where they call Igolo since December 25th. They come from Igolo now, they enter Okoko. From Okoko now, they also go back to Igolo. Then, look at Kaduna don't turn to. City of war.
Kaduna is another country.
With all the military paraphernalia, with this Kaduna, see where he be. So if all of these things, Kaduna be like that, which is a state council for Nigeria, Prague?
Yeah. Because, come for this country. It happened for Kaduna, then a signal to all of us for Nigeria. On Sunday here now, one of our religious leaders, Daddy Adeboye, come talk say, as they don't face Kaduna so, which state be the next state? But the great thing get liver, they face Kaduna. That's it, according to Sidney Shaka, come beat us hollow. Where soldier full everywhere, they enter. What about other states where maybe na Yellow Fever Day or na Boy Scouts Day? Don't have to just invade them. Anyhow. So now we still be our problem. All these problems, and we create them. And if we come up for them, if we change our mind over certain things. As a guy talking just now, do you know that the House Committee on public accounts. Now, Oga Niyi Adebayo, so the House Committee Chairman, go ask. Say they give certificate of acceptance to MTN. That one shows say you don't pay tax. So they give a certificate of acceptance. The amount that they have put now, 2.6 trillion naira. That they have for that certificate. So the committee chairman can say, why if this, you are giving a certificate? Where the money? They don't see where they pay the money. Ajib said they don't pay millions of dollars to government. They still get a certificate of acceptance. Okay, when they don't see $1 million for account. They say they pay several millions of dollars. So now we be our own problems. What they have for Kaduna, now the people there Kaduna Kosam. Don't know allow us to mention names here. Now for there Kaduna, the guys where they create a problem. Because all those people come before 2015. Now this people enter Nigeria. This is how they train them. Before 2015. In case
how you tell us that?
I know where. It full everywhere.
How you tell us say
the internet, the dead newspaper. It full everywhere.
Say it with you.
So
who talk on? Who talk on? Who talk on?
I feel help him.
Okay,
help me.
You know, say recently, Kaduna say governor say if government not tackle the insecurity problem, it will bring mercenaries. He talk on.
So now government.
And what is mercenaries? Mercenaries, anybody you see that can help you fight.
Yes.
Anybody at all, even the one with the chop fire. If we bring our come, you go bring her. So now threat. I write one paper. I can't say, is this a threat or the will to tackle a problem? In a threat, now they threaten the Nigerian nation, say, I will bring. It be like small people say, I will tell my daddy for you. He know, say, if you tell your daddy will take action. Now, he say, if government don't do what he get for mine, he will go bring mercenaries. Government suppose ask the honorable governor, what are those mercenaries? One, where you want to bring them come? Two, where are you already training them? Three, what do you want them to come and do? Four. These are the questions where they supposed
now to. Now they're the facts, so that those are the facts.
No, be you will just say, I will go bring mercenaries come. They will go, there ain't no fee. Concession not allow you. Then you will just debate them like that. That kind of statement when he make, he passed the one where the imam talked for the mosque. Say they will should hold the president responsible for the insecurity within Nigeria. Now he talk. He say he will go bring people come. So now threat to the corporate existence of Nigeria be that. Now not be Nigerian army you won't bring now because you don't get power to deploy army. You know will bring air force. You know will bring police. You will go bring agbero. You will go bring people where they use stick. You will go bring people where they no can do anything that they are currently doing. Remember, there is a video in 2014 when this same man, El-Rufai, governor, then it not be governor, he can say the problem with Nigeria, President Jonathan Fofi Sorghum say the committee where they set up give a recommendation up to 5 points. Now they give and say President Jonathan former, he put on for draw. And now those kind of things where they talk, that time, now I make all Nigeria confused. Say, okay, if these people get the blueprint where the country solve Nigeria's security problem, it means if we give them the power, they will feed one. Now they can't get the power. For 7 years now, the recommendations, when he talked in 2014, he still did draw. Because he said, President Jonathan, they you know, implement single one. We for ask this governor now, how many of those recommendations he don't implement? Part of the recommendation are the use of mercenaries, and who are these people? So it's good to talk, it's cheap. It's good to say. But again, we go to celebrate because it be like person where they cry wolf, when wolf not dead. Now it happen now. The time was, El-Rufai will just shout, hey, they come. Oh, we will do this. Everybody will say, oh, they don't come again. But now they have come. Now we cannot rescue Kaduna State from the hands of this. They say, maybe we don't call them bandits that time. We don't call them terrorists. Maybe we don't call them XYZ. Today, they don't almost overwhelm Nigeria. Now, the Super Tucano, when they go by, over 18 billion, when they use, till they buy these things, they put them for hunger. They nobody feel enter, climb on, even fight. If I talk and they go say, why you say no? See, this man will never come up for Benin. If you they use them, if you deploy them, why be say up till now, Nigeria never see get solution for this insecurity with it. They don't train people according to them. They don't buy the things according to them. They don't, the international law don't allow them, make them use them. Deploy it the way you want it. Where are we? So it is a problem.
Anything about?
You not get past tenants go strong reach for landlord house when the landlord no drive.
So you they say this building they be tenants?
Of course.
But the way they look, it looks as if the problem don't overwhelm government.
See, you not get how rats will disturb the owner of room which when not know where the rats stay. The truth remains that the government knows what to do. If we cannot tackle just bandits and a bandit and terrorist in a little location, now outside the world, we won't go fight. The truth is that these people knows what to do. If they give our armies a marching order to say, okay, this territory, bring it down, they can go and do it. There is some, like what your Oga they told us now, when me not believing. I don't believe in Nigeria factor. Because when they mention Nigeria factor, it talks about negativity. Why should I believe in something that my children will come and suffer at the end of the day? I they go my ward meeting, as I did drive they go, my boy they tell me, say, Chief, that policeman and your person, why you not just blow one way? I say no. Because waiting me especially leaders supposed to they do now to set a good example so that others go follow. But now this our country, we see say, go slow, go day. The very people one we suppose they look up to, they blow the opposite. Now this our country, we see say policemen go they stop people when get numbers or when not get number for their car. But the very car when they take the pursue, you not get back number, not get front number. So now this very country also, you go, they drive, they go, your own car complete, but a road safety go see bus when we say they dance like this, they go let them pass. You when your car complete, they go say, may you park. So what am I telling you? A time has come that we need to praise good name than words. It get where, whether not for Bible I see this thing, or we have for seeing. He said, if you chase money too much, he said the money will become a curse to you. Because as our each other they talk just now, every Nigerian they always think of what is in for me. And because we always think of what is in for me that has to do with money, money has become a cost to every Nigerian. That anything, see, now if person, chief, if they ask you something.
Don't be free.
Don't be free! Chief, if they ask you something, if you call world meeting now, you call NGA money, NGA meeting, or anywhere occasion when you go, if a youth open door for you, guidance for us, a door you open for you. Why? Because we don't make money to be a qualification. You will see a standing professor now, like what did happen of recently. Are you aware that lecturers are the one that made the presidents of the country? If lecturer are not teacher, you know, become presidents. If teacher not teacher, become LGA chairman, or council chairman, or a senator. That is where their foundation be. But now that sector, neither the rubbish pass. I was surprised when fellow lecturer they tell me, say, a professor only earned up to $1 million.
$1 million with it? You even reach $500,000.
It's up to $1,000.
You don't reach $500,000, bros.
That's the truth. Okay.
You don't reach $500,000.
That's gross, not be netto.
You don't reach $500,000.
Net, not $500,000.
That's a big shame.
Okay. But we know if we are, you say, allowance is more than $2 million. Just allowance, won't be normal salary. So you see, why am I saying all this? This Nigerian factor has to die. We need a renewed system, a renewed mind. But how can we do this? Let me tell you when they talk something just now. If the government really wants to make something happen, it will happen. You forget when they call coffee, people don't enter house. No. When they say coffee day, people enter house.
When they say, okay, they catch you, so when you go follow the deity the next morning, irrespective of who you are. Like when you talk just now, saying, no, expect make they come find a professor. Professor, wait, no, see, we need to stop this thing, no. Say, because you dey one position, so therefore, you don't go face with it. See, that they carry a Bakari come. Other people, they handcuff them, join other people. But when you call your wife, Ulam, no matter, even if you are, no matter the position when you dey, no matter if the same punishment will be accord to everybody. Now, this country, when would they say somebody create crime watch? That crime watch that time when they show people, the Oga can enter the same crime, not be my crime watch now. The Oga can be king, the same thing. But that matter how we see him, he not go anywhere. My brother, see, a time has come that we need to do, we need to go back to the drawing board. That words should not make up a man.
Yeah, see, my problem, we are not each other, they told the same line. My problem is that going back to the same drawing boards, now the body language of the leader, now go determine where the people go.
That's why I be leader.
If you enter this ITV now, from gate, now you go know whether this organization is organized or not. Because they will say, open your car. When you come down, they will say, no, you can't open the car by yourself. Check your boots. What is the control? But by the time you drive to my gate, and at the end of the day, how are they? I have brought. You don't already know, say, they don't already compromise the security from the gate. The way will they go so? So many things, they don't compromise it. Before we come here, time not again. I ask Nigerians, when I shall say, all these ministers, this president, vice president, go ebony. They know say this thing that half of this country have been another country today.
They know. They will know past say, as we know. Now because we're not the united as a country, as Nigerians, it gets certain things. Maybe you buy a guy for office now. You never pay your salary for 2-3 months or so. Three of us just plan them. See, for God, come, we not greet them. As you just go, we keep quiet. You go come back, you talk, we not respond. Next day, you don't come work, you come to fear us. But now, we want to do election now. They'll bring one sachet of rice, can't give you. Hey, up chair, you don't win, don't win. You see a person, hey, you don't reduce the reason to the SNC, continue in first picking with 11 years. Now that person you want support. We not say from the start, you don't lie. So most times, if not every time, we not even get any say again. You're like the highest level of poverty. Say, what do you want? Say, anything can serve. You know, so we don't get taste again, not get damage.
Just say we'll come out of this.
Well, if you come out, if youth can't rise up to take over, not by fight, they grow into the electoral system, they can become governor, chairman, the rest.
Now, until those will come over.
Because those elders, they be problem right from time.
Yes, Ichoya.
Yes.
He said, no, wait, means you to come. The way will they go so? Air not safe. Road, train not safe. Road not safe. So before we wait for when the youth go take over, which country do youth want to go take over?
No, Nigeria. Now Nigeria they will talk about. But very quickly too. When you say whether they hear, whether the leader they hear, I will tell you they know they hear. Because somebody they block this information. The president, I'm very sure, may not be able to read by himself. May. You know they read by himself. Now waiting people will tell and say, see waiting they say happen. See waiting they say no happen. Because otherwise, if they hear and see these things, things don't will they go like this. We are too concerned with our politics. Now, they don't roll out packages, so cash money, trader money, unconditional transfer, school feeding, and all of that. These are things you see in the air. Mr. Apololo, what have you done about it? Edo, for example, they told you that Edo is a beneficiary. It's out of the 19 states where they Nigeria, where they do the pilot program for school feeding.
Yes.
Where is it for Edo? Tell me.
How do you want
you don't go see him? Is it true?
No, me, I follow.
You follow?
Yes,
no,
yes.
Say, they feed.
The only thing,
you see the food.
Maybe another thing, we'll discuss another day. time not there again. Yeah, you just say we'll come out for this country.
Yes.
This problem.
You only
time
you,
not there again.
Yes, our Russian, you know, Romans 12 verse 2. It says
you don't deserve that, right?
No, you say
now preaching.
You don't want it because now my you know the abundance of the heart the man speaketh. See, my could tell you, my brother, until a man's mind they renew.
No, see, you two they preach. Okay, and they okay, tell you, okay, say,
situation.
Let me tell you one thing. Let me wrap her up like this. You see what against discipline? Mm. When it still starts, that time. Mm. When he top, move. Mm. The full has all cue.
Yes.
The cue.
Yes.
Now, the body language of the leader.
Yeah,
now,
when they make people the leaders move.
I'm not digging for the program.
Come in, my daughter now.
I don't understand. Let's dig on the free program. We shall not ever do it, Jonas. Frank, thank you for
Thank you.
To get her to come here. And of course, HR, you're always here. Yeah? And
glad to be here.
Our chief, thank you. So, Mude Beragim here is always on point. He's always here, one of our very best cameramen in this country. Peter Umaogi. And all of them, we say, therefore, the production crew, we thank you now, and even the Obe Onke Mawi, even if two of us don't agree.